Elio, it's been a while since I've done a video. I have done actually lots of videos in the background, but as I come to discover about 3 weeks ago, the software on the old phone that I was recording on is no longer being updated, and therefore I cannot upload that video that I have from about 3 weeks ago up onto the channel. So it means I've got to do it using my phone, which not totally happy about. You could argue I should get with the times and, you know, maybe start using laptops and stuff like that, but if truth be told, I don't really want to invest that kind of amount of time in doing it, because it just takes, like, I did it before, like, I think it was like 2018, and I started messing about with the intros a little bit, and they got flagged because the intros were using artists' music and stuff, and so copyright claims, so I had to take the videos down. And the fact that it took the best part of 24 hours to upload a video from the memory card to the laptop hard drive and then process it and all of that. So yeah, I did look on my phone actually to see if I had any editing options on that, because I thought there's a couple of videos that I did do that I wanted to keep, but unfortunately I can't trim and cut and mess about with it the way that I'd want to. So I guess this is the way it's going to be. Anyway, about a minute and a half. Is this a Christmas special? Well, I suppose it is, because Christmas is just around the corner. We're at Christmas Eve Eve, as it were. So it's Saturday the 23rd. And yeah, it's a bit of an interesting time. I've had quite a bit of stuff on my mind that I wanted to talk about. And well, here I am. Now, one of the biggest issues that I personally have at the moment is freedom of speech, for starters, right? Obviously, we got the online safety bill. Now, you can say, well, you can just talk about whatever you want. It's like, yeah, until you start covering certain topics, which might send off a little red light somewhere in some office in the UK, I presume, and might give authority, or the powers that be, reason to start looking into shit that really, on the grand scheme of things, doesn't matter. But we all know that they like making a mountain out of a molehill and making examples of people for literally no reason other than to flex their muscles and to, I suppose, perhaps silence what they regard as being some sort of dissenter just because they have a difference of opinion on a given subject or topic. Yeah, do you know what I mean? It's like, it's not good. It's not good. It really isn't good. And it's all done, as always, in the name of the guise of, oh, public safety. You know, it's not about public safety. It's not. And I don't think so anyway. You know, because it seems that all the time that there are other groups that are actually dissenters and bad generally to a thriving society, which I've got to say, I do sometimes question how much of a society or thriving society both the West and the UK actually have anymore. I suppose it depends on how you view that as to whether it's a thriving society, you know, where you are placed within the yeah, talk about thinking about the wording. maybe even political leanings, actually. That might be a thing too. Because, I mean, look, it's always been a thing. The media just love just tarring everyone as being like far-right extremists just because they said something that was a little bit, you know, spicy perhaps. Or they have a viewpoint that doesn't go with the narrative. So, yeah, just paint them a certain way and call them certain names, and that just solves the problem. And it's like, no, no. Not the fact that they might actually have a point, you know. It's always worth listening to what people have to say, you know. And unfortunately, when it comes down to, because obviously what brought this about was the whole misinformation from 2020 and the internet and people having accounts on many different social media platforms and, you know, talking about the stuff that they wanted to talk about, which absolutely, as far as I'm concerned, they do have a right to do, regardless of whether it goes with or against the narrative of what might be in hair pushed at the time. What bugs me most in all of that is, as always, the air quotes power that be do tend to take two steps back all the time. You know, do this. Yeah, we're the ones in charge. We suggest you do this. It's better for everyone. It's blah 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 safety. Blah blah blah. And I'm not even necessarily talking about the safety bill in this case. I'm just saying generally. And then lo and behold, once they start realizing that, you know, they're going to have to backtrack. Because perhaps it's costing them money, or perhaps it's costing them, if it's a political agenda, it might be costing them votes. So yeah, to try and silence the dissenters or the opposition, you know, you see that a lot, especially in American politics. You know, I'm just saying. So yeah, it kind of makes for wanting to make videos a bit challenging. Because then I've got to seriously think about what I want to talk about, if I want to talk about it, and could there potentially be any repercussions of me talking about something that might be something that I in the audience hold an opinion on, or have an opinion on, which might not go with the narrative. You know, like I've said, you've got other channels out there that have been creating for approximately the same amount of time. And some of them have got well in excess of 100,000 subscribers. Meanwhile, yours truly here. And again, it's not about having a load of subscribers. It's not about me trying to make money off of having a channel. Absolutely not. It never has been. My point is this. My channel has been definitely blatantly thrown under the algorithm and buried by basically anything. Like if you put the channel name in. This is an experiment that I've had friends try, and I've tried it myself, and a lot of the time it doesn't come up with my channel. I kind of don't mind, and I kind of do mind. Catch 22. Because I'm not after internet fame. I'm not trying to make any money off of anyone. I do sometimes think about it, but then I'm like, well, I can't really sit here and call all these other Manosphere content creators grafters. Or no, they're not grafters, they're grifters. There's the difference. Grafters are hard workers. Grifters are just like, you know, snake oil salesmen. You know, a bit like a lot of these life coaches that try and tell these younger generations, they try and sell them a dream if you just buy into their course. And it's like, what really upsets me and all of that is like, yeah, it's all well and good, you know, someone that's already famous, someone that's already successful. Maybe they have good looks, they have good genetics for that, perhaps. And women are attracted to them. And then these guys want to sell courses to the masses that might not have any of that. But yet, if you just pay them $50 a month or whatever it is, I don't know. Right, if you just pay them XYZ amount, then, you know, you're increasing your chances of becoming this giga chad. And it's just like, it's not going to happen, bro. Like, it's just not. Like, there are other ways. You need to save your money rather than shelling out. But again, you know. There's a known saying that it's usually quite soon when a fool is parted from his money. I'm just saying, you know, because a lot of people, I think they want that dream. They want that inspiration to become or to be in a better place than what they are, or to become better than what they are. And they're under the impression that, you know, there's this whole pay to win thing, which seems to be a thing. You know, people are under the impression that if they pay dating coaches, or if they pay life coaches and all of that. And I'm not saying that they're bad all round. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that they're trying to sell something to, I think, a lot of people who, you know, at the end of the day, you are who you are. And it's going to take a mammoth task in order to change, you know, your behavioural patterns that you have developed over the years growing up into adulthood, to then change around all of that. And that includes the worldview that you might have of the world. You could say I'm quite nihilistic, I'm quite, you know, pessimistic rather than optimistic. And I like to see it as I'm more realistic, you know. That's why I've often said, whenever I've done videos, you know, talking about me being on dating sites and the fact that I know that the odds are weighed against me. I'm not 6 foot. I don't consider myself to be that good looking compared to many other guys available on these dating apps and so on. So I kind of expect to not get anywhere with any of the chicks that are on there. Yeah, and I think when it comes down to that as well, is understanding the dynamic that it's always the women that make the choice in who they date and everything else. I'm just going over our ground with that one, but you know the score. But realistically, to try and think that you can change, the way that you are, to a degree, you can make certain changes that will improve your chances. But ultimately, I kind of get disheartened, I suppose is the word, as to a lot of these other channels that seem to think that, if they just charge their clientele money, I mean, look, it makes them rich, I suppose, so there is that to it. But again, I'm not really down with taking people's money off of them for the sake of, an empty promise, something that you might not be able to guarantee them. And of course, that's all in a small print anyway. It's just sort of like, so there's so many guys out there that are just, they're screaming for some sort of help or attention when it comes down to improving their A game on dating, or just generally their A game in women, with women, sorry. And they're under the impression that by paying someone money and learning how to, I suppose, act in certain ways. But again, even if you learn how to act and respond to in certain ways to different conversations that you have with a woman or body language or anything like that, as long as it's like a scripted act, you're always going to find yourself in a position where something comes up to bite you in the bum that you weren't expected, and then it throws you off guard, and then all of a sudden you haven't got a script, and then all of a sudden they're looking at you differently because you're acting different to what you were prior. So yeah, I think it's unfortunate that so many other people just like they just buy into these dating and life coaches and stuff like that. And again, look at their past, One of the things that we say a lot in the sort of manosphere regarding dating and women is like, look at their past. And it's like, well, the same thing you have to do with life coaches. It's the same thing, you can't, or dating coaches, like realistically, if they're not in a successful, happy relationship and that, and they're trying to say something, it's like, don't you think there's a problem with that? If they're that good at what they do, would they not have achieved what they've achieved already? Or do they know the truth and they're just not telling the masses, I'm just saying, but they're still quite happy to take your money from you because why not? And it can still look like they're helping you. And I suppose to a degree it kind of does help you, but in some cases there's a with some of these individuals there's a lot of toxic manipulation that goes on, which I'm not down with either, because there's enough of that coming from the air quotes fairer sex when it comes down to that. I'm just saying. So yeah, that's kind of been like the general gist of things for me at the moment. So not a great deal has changed. Christmas time, yeah, I do tend to have that thing. Like I usually do a video at Christmas time, and I'll talk about that thing of like, people don't want to be, a lot of people don't want to be on their own for Christmas. They'd rather be in a relationship, or because if they're going around for a family meal or something like that, and it's like, you get asked, oh, have you got a partner yet? You got a girlfriend? You got a boyfriend? Yada yada. This works both ways. And it's like a lot of people, I suppose, like myself, it's like I'm not really looking at like in a lot of cases the idea or the ideal of having a girlfriend and stuff like that. But I think realistically, when I look at me, the options for what they really are, and I'm not too impressed with that either, because a lot of the time, people or chicks around my own age, a lot of the time they're gonna have kids already, so echo chamber time. So with that, I'm not gonna be a priority in a relationship. There's gonna be the kids, the friends, pets, family, in fact a lot of other things that will become a priority long before the guy becomes a priority, if he ever becomes a priority in the first place. So that kind of puts me on kind of like a bit of uneven ground with regards to that one, because you do it several times and you see and recognize a pattern for what it is, and you get to the point where it's sort of like, well, I want to do that again. Why would I want to do that again? It's just like, no, I can't see that, having a potential air quotes happy ending, as it were. Even though I had a chat with one of my mates, and he sort of said, oh yeah, but even if you could find the love of your life and all this, and I'm sitting back and I'm thinking, I'm listening to him. He's going on about, oh yeah, but you have a right to have your what your prerequisites, I suppose, for what you kind of expect from a woman in a relationship. But at the same time, like, do you not think you could be cutting yourself short just by rejecting someone that has got kids with someone else? And it's like, well, just to put this one out there, it's like if you try something multiple times with different people, but it's a similar sort of situation, and you're always getting the same outcome, and you've done this six, maybe seven times, or maybe five or six times, right? At which point do you think, actually, you know what, this just doesn't work for me? You're not going to find that true love with that, because they can't meet you on an even keel. They can't provide that to you because they have other responsibilities and other priorities, and you're just not one of them. So I kind of get a little bit tetchy sometimes when people say things like that to me, and it's sort of like, bro, are you stupid? Like, are you not paying attention to anything that I've been through in my life? Especially for people that know me, it's like, have you not paid attention? It's like, if you're gonna sit there and be like, oh well, you chose these women, it's like, no, these women chose me, right? I agreed to go along with it because I thought you could make something out of these things. Ultimately, in the same that they chose perhaps the Chad or Tyrone or whatever, Pookie or Ray Ray that had they had offspring with. You know, they also chose them, knowing full well that they weren't going to stay around. Maybe hoping that, you know, having offspring with them was going to achieve one of two things: either A, get the guy to stay, or B, a guaranteed income and a roof over their head in some cases where that might be a thing. But ultimately, they chose me. I liked them, they chose me for whatever reason. And like I say, when you have this happen to you know, like once or twice, you can be like, all right, okay, maybe it's just a bit of bad luck. But when it's like five times consecutively, it's like, no, there's a bigger problem, and there's no love that can be offered from a relationship where you are not a priority. It's as simple as that. You know, and people don't like hearing that because it's the truth. Just saying. But yeah, and it's just sort of like, I sometimes wonder, like, is that thing of like, do we need to lower our standards? And I'm like, absolutely not. No, we need to raise our standards even more. If anything, like, you know, like, why would you want to be second? Why would you want to come second, like, to anyone? Like, don't make excuses like, oh yeah, but if they've got kids. And it's like, no, they that is a decision that they made prior to meeting, like, you, as it were. Right, that's something that just, it didn't just fucking happen, right? They didn't just wake up one day and then there was this kid at the end of the bed. No, that all took a whole load of process, regardless of what happened, regardless of the situation, and again, regardless of what you get told, because unfortunately, a lot of people in this day and age just, they struggle telling the truth. Do you know what I mean? And it's like, I can't. This is why I can't deal with society the way that it is. You've got so many people, I'm not necessarily talking about women or single mums in this case, right? But you've got so many people running around just chatting shit, lying, making out that there's something out there, not looking like absolute dicks at every single step when they get caught out, they're caught up in a lie, you know. And the thing is, these people don't do anything to rectify it. They just carry on and make it worse. And you know, what I think is sad is the amount of people that actually entertain these kind of clowns in their life. I'd be like, no, like, I do not want to be involved with someone that just cannot tell the fucking truth. I just don't. Why would I want that? You know, I don't want to sit there trying to decipher whether the next sentence that come out of their mouth was a lie, or if they want to tell me something that happened. Do I now have to think like, oh, well, they what actually happened? Because I know this person has an issue telling the truth. You know, I can't be arsed dealing with that. You know, that's why for me, Christmas isn't so much about family time, it's more about getting the fuck away from everyone. I don't like people and their bullshit. It's just, I don't know what it is, whether it's like fragile egos or something like that. I don't know what it is, but whatever it is, man. Like, and it's a combination. And unfortunately, and I'll say it for what it is, but some of the women that I've had the mispleasure of meeting throughout my life, you know, they're the worst ones. Like, talk about lying to yourself to like make yourself feel better about whatever the situation, and it's just sort of like, no. No, absolutely not. But yeah. So as always, my Christmas videos are a right rare sunshine, yeah. Like I say, this is the thing with like creating content like this. It's just, it is an echo chamber, man. That's why I've stopped creating content and like, you know, there's certain things that I can and can't talk about anymore because online safety bill. Yeah, they care so much about the safety that they try and wipe out half the fucking country. Yeah, and then backpedal and say, well, we didn't make anyone do anything. So yeah, of course you didn't. Of course you didn't. No, you didn't threaten to like not let people go places and buy stuff and yeah. You didn't do that at all, no. But that's you might have noticed there's been a quick swift topic change there, but it's because that's also relevant because it goes back to what I was just talking about being fucking lied to by people that you're supposed to have faith and trust in, you know. Politicians. The two words that don't even go with that the word politician. Trust, honesty, respect, but more importantly, greater good. Yeah. These are all the things that is wrong with the current political system. Those words don't exist unless it's in reference for themselves and their benefit. It ain't for the people. Fuck it. Anyway, as I was saying, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. It's going to be a fucking right scream 2024. Hopefully things will change for the better. I've heard a video. I was just doing a video today. Things do seem to be picking up ever so slightly, but we'll see how it goes. Anyway, right, now that I've cheered you all up for Christmas, have a very Merry Christmas. And if I don't do a video between now and New Year, have a Happy New Year too. So until the next one, stay cool, stay free. Peace out.